Welcome to Whiskey.com, where fine spirits meet. My name is Lüning, Horst Lüning. I'm the senior taster of Whiskey.com, and today we have a closer look to the Deanston Virgin Oak 46.3 ABV, unchill filtered, and priced relatively low in the 30s. This is a single malt whiskey without an age statement on it, but this one is finished in virgin oak, means fresh oak used the first time for a cask. The Deanston Distillery is a old cotton mill, I think. It's a mill and resides at the River Teith. That's the name, yeah. And it was closed in the 1980s in the big recession, and then reopened in 1991. And then they changed what they are doing. They switched over to local ingredients. They use regenerative power. They have a power plant there, which runs since the cotton mill was built then. And they try to be as regional, as local as possible. Yeah. The new Deanstons, which are on the market already for 5-7 years, I think, you can recognize them by the 46.3 ABV, which is necessary to be unchill filters and not getting hazy if you dilute it with water. They show this is the strength, a new strength of the Deanston. The old ones are, I think, they are gone, yeah, from the shelves. There's close to nothing left. And the virgin oak, it's got its place on the shelves. And the distillery, I think, belongs to the Bern Stewart company, Scotch company. But I think this was sold, and they are together in a group with the Tobermory Lijik Distillery and the Bunnahevan from the Isle of Islay, and all together have these 46.3 ABV and have those different maturations and finishing in fresh casks. So this is a joint effort by those distilleries. A wonderful cork. Very nicely cut. Yeah. And we visited the distillery some years ago, took wonderful videos there. So if you like it, go into the whiskey database on whiskey.com, search for this distillery Deanston, and then you get the video of the distillery where you can see all this old water power station, hydro power station. And those casks lying in the yard. So this distillery made a very, very big leap forward. Yep. Light citrus notes. So this shows I'm younger, apple, young, fresh. No alcohol. 46.3 and no alcohol, that means the additional aromas are stronger than the alcoholic note. Mm-hmm. Lightly sweet, malt, of course, malt whiskey, and a beginning oakiness. So this is a friendly, intense, voluminous note in the nose. Yeah. Slange. Mm-hmm. Oily, juicy, and then the fresh virgin oak kicks in, gives a a recognizable light oakiness, tannins, moving over to bitterness. So they had the whiskey matured in, Kentucky bourbon casks. They were reused, probably reused, and because they were so neutral or not heavily matured, they added some time in those virgin casks, and this gives this intense oak note. The aftertaste is not bitter. The bitterness vanishes, but it's strong, intense, lasting aftertaste. The oak is present, spicy, and candied fruits. So here it shows a little bit of age in the aftertaste. The aftertaste is first lightly sharp or peppery, and then moving over to a smoother, more oily aftertaste. I remember I had that whiskey 5 to 7 years ago, and I was astonished how well it was done and how well these fresh virgin oaks harmonize with the whiskey and gives them this light ginger peppery spicy note on the tongue. No bitterness. Then when the spiciness vanishes, then a light delicate bitterness appears for a short time, and then in the longer aftertaste, not more. I like that. Very well done. Thank you very much for watching. Stay tuned, there's more to come.